Now we are joined by Siobhan O'Neill. Are you there on the line, Siobhan?
I'm here.
How are you doing?
Good. Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks very much for joining us. Siobhan O'Neill White from mams.ie, the parenting website. 9 weeks of school holidays looming large for parents and bored children. We had Jennifer O'Connell on from the Irish Times earlier. In some people's minds, when you mention school holidays, it just sends a shiver of terror down their back, doesn't it?
It does. And I have two teenagers. So one of them is here at the moment because she's a first-year teenager in first-year secondary. And she's just, can I go? Can I have? Can you do? So she's driving me mad already. And the other lad is doing his junior cert, so he's not annoying me yet, but he will be next week. And then the two little ones will be out at the end of the month and all hell breaks loose because you have four to entertain.
You have to kind of plan your entire sort of summer in terms of parents around the children's holidays, don't you? Because you have to try and think, well, you want to try and take a holiday yourself. It's a good time to take it. And then you've got the whole issue of child minding. You've got grandparents being pulled in, neighbours, relatives. And then the children hear of other children going away on holidays. Mm. And they are sitting at home thinking, why am I doing that?
Yeah, well, go and ask the government about that one. I'm not going to answer that question. But there's loads of things, there's loads of places you can go and there's loads of things that you can do. And, you know, you don't have to spend an absolute fortune. So if you have, you know, kids of all ages, a really good place to go when you have kind of kids, you know, from babies up to teens is Fota Island Resort, because they have everything. There's a fairy wood, there's the hotel, of course, but they also have cottages. So if you want to make it a little bit less expensive for yourself, you can still stay on the grounds. And then, of course, you're attached to the Fota Wildlife Park as well. There's then Cove is just down the road. Kinsale is just down the road. Actually, Cove is fabulous. We went and did Spike Island last year. And to sell the mobile phone service is really bad over there, which is the best thing because our teenagers had to get off their phones for the day. And we absolutely loved it. That is a brilliant thing to do.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
So that's a good one. If you're looking for a family break and you're on a budget, there are places and there are good deals. Look around. You will find some good deals. There's a hotel on the East Coast, if you fancy coming up a little bit near East Mead, the Village Hotel in Bettystown, and they're right beside the beach. And I was looking for the best deals I could find. Two adults, two kids, two nights with breakfast and a dinner and access to a pool and stuff is €335. That's very, very, very good. So that would be on the other end of the scale if you are on a budget.
The other thing, Siobhan, is this idea, I suppose, you can use the summer holidays. It's very simple to reconnect with your children.
Oh, God, definitely.
Literally,
definitely.
Just get on the bus, go out to Tramore, go down to Ardmore, wherever it is, go down onto the beach. Bring a packed lunch and spend
the best thing.
Yeah, and just, you know, just reconnect and talk to your children.
What we would do with the kids is we would bring, obviously you have your buckets and spades and everything. So the beach, when we go to the beach, we bring buckets and stuff and we get the kids to collect seashells. And then we come home and when we have a day where they're bored and we want to do something, I set them up outside in the back garden. I give them the seashells. They wash them, they dry them, they paint them. Put a bit of newspaper down. This takes hours to do. They'd let them all dry off and then we'd go and buy a cheap, colourful tumbler in Tesco or Deals or something like that. And hey presto, there's a gift for Granny. And it's a cheap, every parent has paint and things around the house.
Yeah.
So that's a really, really cheap activity and kids actually love that. They love to do baking. And also, if you are going to take your kids out, so like, there would be special things that we will do with our kids. So like things like, say, Viking splash tours, things like that. You know, you're going to take them out, or the wax museum, something like that. I will say to my children, OK, so we're going to go and do that on Thursday. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I want you to help me around the house on Monday. And then Tuesday, I want you to help me clean the car. I make them work for it. And we should be making them work for it because you're going to take them out and you're going to spend money. And of course, they deserve to have a lovely day. But I try to get my kids to earn it a little bit. And I think there's nothing wrong with that.
That's a good idea, yeah. Very,
so
very good idea.
They're not being totally spoiled. And if you are going to go up to Dublin and you have teenagers, places like the National Concert Hall in Dublinia is very good. It kind of has a macabre vibe going on, and teenagers love that. Things like the Viking Splash, I brought the Granny on that, and she absolutely loved it. There's loads of things that you can do. I mean, look, Waterford has so much stuff going on, but sometimes you might want to go, you know, out of that area. We went over to Portumnor Forest Park last year and it's completely free. You bring a picnic, you walk around, and the amount of animals and birds and It was amazing. The kids were climbing trees. We were looking at, we were running after frogs. So, you know, there's actually loads of free things that you can do. You don't have to be constantly running around with them to places that...
No, you don't.
You know,
don't.
Cost a fortune. And I know we've got Centre Parks coming this year and they've got some indoor stuff going on. But there's, again, there's loads of hotels down in, down around Waterford area. You've got like Amber Springs there in Wexford. Everything you need is in one place. So if you do have small children, a hotel like that is good because it's contained. Everything you need is just there. So, you know, the parents, you can get a little bit of a rest because they have kids clubs and things like that. But the summer, you know, I'd say let the kids have a bit of freedom as well. Go to the beach, go for your nature walks. Even I like to go for a run on the beach and I get the kids to come with me and I say, okay, they can time me, or they'd be saying, Mammy, drop and give us 20. They think it's great. They're like little sergeants. They are behind me telling me what to do. Get your kids involved. And also, not just to leave them with the grandparents. I tried to bring the grandparents. And we tried to make, you know, we went to Airfield Estate. It's up near the Dublin Mountains last year. And brought the mother. And sure, myself and herself did the zip line. And the kids thought it was the funniest thing. And they're still talking about it. So, again, it doesn't have to be a big, expensive thing. There's lots of things that you can do, you know, that you can involve the whole family. There's also loads of festivals going on this year. The Fun Fest is on in Taylor Park at the end of June, and that's specifically a family festival. So there's music and activities and things going on. And it's just, you know, it's really aimed at families. It's very inclusive to children, because a lot of festivals are not really inclusive to children. Yeah. So I think it's good that we have one that actually is. And then you might want to send them to a summer camp. I try to find summer camps that are a little bit different. So this year my kids are going to a summer camp where they're going to learn how to make a movie. So you'll know most kids now, they have tablets, iPads, and they're little whizzes when it comes to YouTube and making little movies and stuff. So my kids are going to star camps and they're actually going to learn how to edit and make a movie. So it's like they're going to actually learn something, but they're going to have fun. And that's a nationwide camp. I think that's a good one if you have a child who's a bit creative.
Yes, absolutely.
And then another kind of a quirky camp is Bricks for Kids, where they learn through STEM learning, so science, technology, through the use of Lego play. And that's nationwide as well. So they're learning like science and maths and engineering, and they don't even know that they're doing it, because as far as they're concerned, sure, they're just playing with Lego.
Siobhan O'Neill-White from mams.ie. I know there's a lot more up on the website, mams.ie.
Yeah,
please check it out. Thank you.
Free.
Thank you very much for joining us this morning, as ever. Siobhan O'Neill-White from mams.ie. Great to hear from you there this morning. Keep your texts and comments coming in about what to do with your children over the summer.